I wash my hands in your face. I wash my face with your face. To start the day again. To start each day again. You take me by the hand. Your face is turned away, high above me, silhouette against the moon. You take me by the hand. Your face is turned away, but your fingers let me know where your gaze is fixed. A bird swoops low. Your fingers let me know there is a storm coming. I turn at that moment to the island. There is a small boat docking at one of the coves. I can just make out a tiny figure clambering ashore, dragging the boat after it. I have the curious impression, a child's fantasy, that it is me, myself. Transfixed, I watch as I stumble ashore through the breakers, small bundle in my arms. I feel your hand grip mine and squeeze. At the top of the bay road, we halt in anticipation, and gradually, slyly, as if by surprise, I increase our pace until we are both running, stumbling, skipping, flying down the hillside toward the seashore, sea breeze in our faces. You always chuckle then, a kind of stifled choke, the only time I ever hear a laugh from you. I stop, just in time for the waves to lick our toes, breathless, joyous in the spray, your hand still gripping mine. Gradually you relax it, and I can feel in the vanishing pressure of your grip the disappearance of your smile, the return of your mask. One time in my excitement I run too far, and before I can stop, a huge wave engulfs us. Our hands slip apart in the gasp of ice-cold ocean. I freeze, you freeze. For what seems an endless moment, an ocean lies between us. All I can see of you is your hand, grasping, talon-like for mine. I am aware of my own hand, free. There are those who insist you drowned that day. There are those who insist you survived that wave, caught in an undertow. But I felt your grip. I felt your grip. I remember walking back up the hill, hand in hand, hand in hand, the laborious march back home. I wash my hands with your face. I wash my face with your face. To start the day again. To start each day again.
There are elements in this piece which are actual relevant to today's political situation, to the situation of the migrants fleeing their countries in war-torn places. And I think this is a very good topic, and you've chosen a very complicated but very serious theme for a dance piece.
There's a lovely line in your text which says, the laborious march.
Hand in hand.
That kind of was quite emotive to me. I kind of got the sense of people, you know, gathering themselves up.
Yeah.
And moving on. Mm-hmm. And having a sense of support to each other. That okay. No matter what happened, they were going to stay together and maybe find a new place. So I suppose they're social.
Yeah, so even though they were exiled, dispossessed, yeah, without anywhere to belong, they still had the belonging to each other.
Belonging to each other, exactly.
Yeah, the connection.
So then when Daire joined me, I thought, well, this could, you know, the duet could be quite close, and mm-hmm, the arms, and then you had a lovely moment, the opening of your text, which was, I wash
my hands with his face.
Yeah. That then was, for us, became quite real in the studio.
Yes.
Looking into kind of pools of water, and then it was just a lovely image of it, of bodies crossing over each other with their hands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the image of things lapping over each other, and waves, is kind of repeats, doesn't it, mm-hmm, throughout the whole thing.
It does,
whether
yeah,
it's hands or water.
And then, of course, that then emphasised to me, you know, the imagery of those images of people being lost, mm-hmm, under a wave, the migrants you know, tossed under waves, and some of them survived. Which that was in your text, which was strange.
There were those who insisted drowned that day. Caught in an undertow.
Right. That was very powerful to me when I heard it first.
Right. It was kind of resonating off what you were seeing going on around you in the world.
Yeah. And so then how did we respond to that, really, in the movements?
Well, we interpreted it together.
Yeah, exactly.
The movement came out from the text, basically.
Yeah.
With a lot of discovering and a lot of trying, researching.
Yes, researching, yeah.
Hours and hours of researching in the studio.
Yeah.
To make the pictures come alive.
Yeah.
That was the first time
The emotions and the physical reality.
The first time I worked with dancers, it was interesting to see the text play off the movement of the dancers when you were working together.
Yeah. And I think also, now that we've had that experience, we're looking now at developing the text as a kind of almost a sound score for the dance. I'm hoping to develop the work for four dancers, actually, two female and two male dancers, and perhaps do four solos of their interpretation of, you know, isolation within themselves, maybe something that reaches out further, as we've worked on the social aspect of it, and then a number of duets, possibly two and two, you know, two females, two males, or male female. But we've done the male female. We've started on our research.
That's